was it. This is Ru, Kaika, I'm Kavika, and this is Kainoa.
Is that recording right now?
Yeah.
Oh. Shut up, Kaz Jane.
Okay, anyways. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Got Andres, Brian, Kaika, and myself, and here's their Instagrams. It'll be right over their heads. Today we're going to be reviewing our Filmmaker and Friends react to Friends videos or edits. So first off, we're going to be watching Nolan's one, Reviving Our Reefs. He filmed this back in about January, posted it in March of 2020, and let's have a look.
Holy fuck, someone disliked this video. What a snake.
In January of 2020, myself and two friends took a trip to Mo'orea, one of the 118 islands of French Polynesia in the South Pacific, in hopes of learning about the efforts being made to preserve coral life. After waking up to a beautiful view, we decided to hit the road and explore this amazing island. We traversed the windy roads until we reached Belvedere Lookout, located in the center of the island.
Wow, it looked like Tatlas.
We witnessed a view too good to be true. Hiking through the tropical forests of Mo'orea all morning, we soon realized that we needed to cool off in the crystal clear waters surrounding the island. We borrowed a kayak from a friendly local and made our way to the sandbar. It pains me to say that this beautiful ecosystem is in danger because the coral reefs are disappearing.
Oh! Nolan's not scared, huh?
Yeah.
Punch my boy Steve Urban died from that.
The next day, we finally met the coral gardeners. They call themselves the Children of the Ocean, and their mission is to save the coral reefs. We were glad to meet them, not only to hear how we can save the coral reefs, but they also prepared a traditional French Polynesian meal for us. Poisson crew is usually prepared with raw fish, pure coconut milk, fresh tomatoes, and lime.
Is that coconut milk?
Yeah. Brian likes coconut. Oh, they can.
This video is sponsored by Corona or something.
Yeah.
Coral gardeners are passionate volunteers for many countries around the world.
I'm glad you didn't say it.
After learning about coral, they insisted on showing us around by boat.
This guy?
No.
He's sponsored by a lot of stuff.
We saw the problem with our own eyes. The coral reefs are dying. Almost half of the world's reefs have been lost in the last 40 years.
You know what that is.
A few main causes: overfishing, pollution,
How can you save them, Brian?
The coral gardeners are working to combat this problem by planting coral of their own.
Yeah, build your own.
They set up nurseries and find pieces of coral that were broken off and plant them into a new home by means of drilling. Last year, they planted over 11,000 corals. To see the success that the coral gardeners have, we returned by night.
I think you have to talk louder. I don't know if the microphone's
witnessing the coral nursery alive and blooming gives me a newfound sense of hope.
A lot of profanity you're using.
I know.
Are you gonna leak it out?
Maybe. Under each layer of beauty, there seems to be another one that is even more beautiful. But Mo'orea showed me that the beauty of our planet is fragile and in danger. The most effective action is to spread word and educate others. We are all children of the ocean.
That's right. Sponsored by Corona.
Okay, bottle now.
I don't even know he went to French Polynesia, that's for sure.
Honest thoughts.
That's pretty smooth.
I like the cause. Short, simple, sweet. Under 4 minutes.
I like the sharks.
Cute.
And the sharks.
The sharks and the sharks.
So you only like the sharks out of this whole video.
And he's talking about saving the ocean. Yes, sir.
Thank you for those kind words.
Brian, you can lead this whole...
Up next, we have my friend Daniel's video. It's a simple 1 minute edit. This was as my year 2019, I think. Pretty solid. I'm featured in it a couple times. And there we go.
Diamond hit?
Yep. Where it took you.
Okay. Not too bad.
Oh, where we want to go.
Okay.
What's that at?
Timeless. I don't know where that is.
I don't know where that is.
Is it?
I don't know.
I think that is me.
That's me. Backflip underwater with a rock.
I never catch one fish.
A bunch of hyperlapses, which is super cool.
Oh man. Holy sh. This is dope.
Yeah, when I saw it, I was like, Daniel, this is sick.
This is dope.
I like cry. It feels beautiful.
Yeah, that was nice.
Good job, Daniel.
That shit was hard.
I give it a 10 out of 10. Any words start from Brian?
Oh, it was nice. How you did that thing where you zoom out in the camera at H3 and it's like far in the sky?
It's called a drone, Brian.
He said that was mean.
It was mean.
Well, Daniel, when you see this, be sure to thank him on Instagram. Up next is my friend Evan. He's a super talented filmmaker. He does a lot of interview style type of edits, which is super sick. I've worked with him on these two, and these are just really sick. Let's check out the first one from 1938 Indochine from Kevin Aoki's restaurant. Here we go.
Oh, it man. Oh, shit.
Where is it at?
Yeah.
My name is Kevin.
Just kind of like
a restaurant tour.
I don't know. It's kind of new.
And this is my new restaurant.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, what is that? Holy, it's surf cigar.
Only if you know.
French colonized in Southeast Asia. The countries comprised were Vietnam, Thailand, Laos, and Cambodia, and they called that area Indochine. During that time, the French had a large influence on the culture, the architecture, and food. As you can see here, the bones are French, the layers are Chinese colors, and Vietnamese decadence. The best food in Southeast Asia is found on the street. So our inspiration is the food vendors of Southeast Asia. When you come into the restaurant, we're trying to bring the outdoors in. The center of the restaurant is kind of like a courtyard. On the right side of the restaurant, you're almost like in the street. So we've added two street bikes there. They're old school chopper style bikes. Asia is like a motorbike culture. Everyone's on bikes. If you're in a car, you're not moving. On top of the bikes, I have this slogan called Racing is Life. And Racing is Life was really a...
Oh my god.
Yes, sir. You gotta take that. You gotta take that.
It's from Alex.
You should get that tatted on you. Racing is Life. Put that right here.
No!
Where on your right here on your face,
yeah,
on belly.
Yeah, the life philosophy of Stephen King,
shit.
And it made a big impact on me.
It won't pause.
Some of our chicken raw, chop chai, and you gotta try the crazy fried rice.
Right here.
Right here.
I'm sorry about
life,
that.
Right here.
A life philosophy of Stephen McQueen, and it made a big impact on me. To create this authentic experience, we traveled to Southeast Asia and hand selected each piece that you see here, from the floor to the terracotta tiles on the wall, to all the panels that you see, to the 300 shutters alongside the windows. They're all found in Southeast Asia.
So for
guests that
windows.
Want more of an intimate experience,
straight off the houses.
We have a really cool area upstairs where there's booths all lined up.
I'm not eating that right now.
That's some rich.
Our outdoor
dining
area has over 20 tables.
Yeah, let me get that window.
Covered trellises. Trellises are made to repurpose people from Java, Indonesia. Our chefs in our kitchen come from Vietnam.
You can do that. Oh, Brian, you should work over there. Oh, that's your job right there. Go work over there.
Dishes, like the colonial crab cakes, the lemongrass fries, and the oyster sugar trio. Some of our traditional dishes are like the Vietnamese pork chop, the chicken lox, chop chai, and you gotta try the crazy fried rice.
Holy fried rice.
We are excited to share the Indochine era with you. Look forward to
seeing
you.
I don't think they'll eat that.
They will.
Okay. That's not going to die.
1938 Indochine. That was a super solid video. Up next we have Rocky Teppanyaki by Evan again.
That's
super
Benihana's.
Cool. Yep. Well, basically.
Oh, a Rainbow Tower.
Oh, that's his old job.
Oh,
shit. Hit this guy for discounts.
Okay. Hit him up for
discounts, Hilton discounts.
Chairs and umbrellas.
Yeah. No.
He's single, ladies.
Rocky Oh, yes, sir. You drown. I save your life.
Oh, God. I don't know if I want that. Let me die.
What the fuck?
Okay. All right.
Rocky Teppanyaki has been in the Hilton Hawaiian Village for 50 years. It's an amazing milestone that any restaurant
down.
Could survive 50 years and still stay relevant
new
to customers.
Owners.
Just as it was 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 30 years ago. People love to celebrate their birthdays, anniversaries, and special occasions at Rocky's. So going forward, what I want to do is just really hone in on the basics of what makes Teppanyaki so special and bring it here to Hawaii.
Rocky Aoki was an amazing innovator in terms of bringing Japanese food to Americans' consciousness, and this is a family restaurant that is a continuation of his legacy. When my wife, Devin Aoki, and Stephen Aoki asked me to get involved,
Kevin's brother's
it was natural
Steve
to bring in the Aoki group and Kevin, because it's a family business and Kevin has a history of excellence in running restaurants.
I know Kevin for about 30 years now, and it's great that he's leading our new team here. I'm looking forward to working with him again.
So the management change to Kevin Aoki as the manager is effective now. We will kind of be bringing back the menu to more traditional Japanese teppan style fit.
If my dad were here today, he'd be very proud. After 50 years of this
you
restaurant,
cook
healthy,
like that?
We have the family back
out.
Together. My brother Steven and my sister Devin, when they asked
you
me
burn
to
burn the whole restaurant down.
I was very proud to help.
Our Noel's gonna sit at your table the way you cook so slow.
So I'm gonna take
your electric frying pan
and bring it back to this restaurant.
That's nice.
So that's Evan's work.
I'll walk past that restaurant every day for like 3 years straight. Never even bothered to go inside.
So now you're gonna go inside?
Maybe.
Okay, up next we got Micah Ni'inuma. He is one of the first guys I got inspired by. Super sick editor. And this is all the way down in his like the bottom of his feed, so kind of got to dig deep for these, so we'll watch this first one and then the second one right after.
Hey, yes, sir.
Let's throw a lemon all the reservoir.
Oh, that's clean.
Yeah, Micah's kind of like a god of editing.
Hey, what the fuck is that?
Oh, back to a time where freaking.
Did someone get through a pizza?
That was a cake.
What?
Okay, and then up next we got his Don't Leave edit. Super sick.
That is cake?
Yeah.
Don't.
This one was super sick.
Where's that?
I don't even know.
Oh!
That's the kind.
That's
Tahiti.
That picture edit was my favorite one. That was nice.
I was watching the David Dobrik's vlog. David Dobrik's podcast, The Views.
Yeah.
And he had Madison Beer on it.
Yeah.
And it was pretty good. I think they did one about they did this one game where it was like they whisper something to one person and that person says it's either you or you, or like whoever they're picking between. I think it's called Paranoia. So if I'm like Kaiko, who is the most laziest? You point to Brian. But then he won't know because it's between me and him.
Yeah,
and we'll flip a coin. If it lands on heads, he'll never find out. If it lands on tails, we have to tell him. So we can try something like that. You got a coin. Pick a number 1 through 4.
So it says 4.
4.
4. Okay, so you're 4. Pick a number 1 through 3.
3.
2, so that's you.
Okay.
So now you two tell something and it has to be between me and Brian.
Okay, okay. So you tell me or I tell you?
You tell you, Kaika, and Kaika has to pick.
Okay, okay. And it can be anything?
Anything.
Alright.
Oh, no.
Oh! Okay. So you flip the coin?
No, no, no. We just, we're gonna, what is it? You pick who first.
I did.
Oh, me?
Yeah.
Okay, flip the coin.
Wait, so heads...
Heads, you're safe. Tails, you gotta tell me.
Oh.
Oh, you're safe.
Oh,
you landed on heads.
Okay, okay.
Okay, so yes, I guess now it's me and Brian, so...
I like, no, you fucker.
No, Brian.
You can't.
That's not part of the game.
I'm having thoughts, M.I.A.
You go sit down.
What the fuck?
You point out.
Did you guys point already?
No.
Get the point.
Alright.
Oh, shit.
You gotta tell him?
Right, you gotta.
Oh, Brian.
I guess I have to. I pretty much asked him who's more gay.
Oh.
What the fuck?
I knew it was you. I knew it was you. So you
are you serious?
Ways. He taught you all your ways, right? I knew it. I knew it.
I didn't teach you, bro.
I don't
want to
hear you say anything about me teaching this man.
Do you want me to pull up the receipts?
What receipts?
Oh, no, no, no.
Oh, hell no.
You can't do it. You can't do it.
Oh, hell
no.
No
receipts. No
receipts.
That's
a false claim.
Pick a number 1 through 4.
That's a false claim.
Okay, 3 again. Pick a number 1, 2, or 4.
What the fuck?
56. Pick a number 1 through 4. Well, oh. Wait, that's me and Brian again.
Yeah.
Okay, then we'll do a different one. On, you want to just do us two?
Yeah, right. You guys can.
I'm pretty sure something happened. Brian?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Brian!
Yeah, bro. Yeah.
I hope it's heads.
I hope it's tails.
I hope it's tails, bro.
What is it? What is it? What is it? What is it? Is it tails?
Yeah.
So you can't know?
No, I have to tell him. It was... Who kissed the guy before?
Me! What
don't,
the fuck?
No, 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 no! No, 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 you can't even...
Tyus kissed me.
Yeah.
Tyus kissed you?
He did. Tyus kissed me, I looked at him like, what the f***, Tyus?
So you did kiss him, man.
No, he kissed
Tyus,
me.
Tyus, you've just been exposed.
Alright, okay. So now it's me, right?
Alright.
Oh, shit.
God damn it,
you're
Tyus.
You're gonna tell me something, or... I tell you.
What? Wait, what? What?
Brian, what the? Whatever, man. If that's the one you want, that's the one you want.
Oh, yeah, man.
Wait, don't flip it yet. But I choose Rue.
Okay, let's hear it.
Okay, flip it.
Oh, you're safe.
It's good. You guys didn't want to know what this man said.
Okay, this one is me and Andres now, so...
You gotta preserve the rice a little bit.
This one is going to Brian.
What the f***?
Sorry, Brian.
You can't flip it, Brian. You can't flip it. Nothing doesn't flip it.
Let it hit the table or catch it.
Doesn't matter.
Yes!
Oh!
Say that shit.
Say that shit.
Alright.
Spill it to me.
Spill a bean.
We said who's more likely to pick up a dude at a bar. We chose Brian.
Sorry, Brian.
Don't underestimate either of them, Brian. Choose wisely.
This is kind of hard.
I know.
Dude,
don't know.
They're both equal in this one.
What is that supposed to mean? It's like Bron and MJ.
I think I know what this is.
I hope it's correct, Brian. I hope it's correct.
That's the country.
Me?
Yeah.
Mm.
Oh.
Yes.
And I want to.
Damn, bro.
So he doesn't have to talk?
Yeah.
I already know who I'm gonna pick.
I have one more, bro.
Dude,
it could be anyone. Don't underestimate him.
No, actually, I don't even know anyone.
Oh, snap.
Wow. We have to get tells to get told?
Yeah. I think.
This is like this.
What the
f? Oh, shit. Oh shit.
What is this, Brian?
Nah, I honestly think it'll be Brian because one day Brian's gonna be super drunk. And then, next thing you know, he's just gonna be like that.
Brian, you better hope this tells.
Oh shit.
Girl.
Brian's getting told today! Come back, Brian, come back!
It was, who's more likely to get pegged in the ass? You're just gonna get carried away with your girlfriend in. She'd be like, get on your knees.
What the fuck?
See, at least it's not a dude, bro. It's a girl. It makes it all better.
Okay, that's it for today's video, guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks again for watching, guys. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace. She said she wanna ride.